ruin. Jedi, you're about to witness it. After weeks of work, finally, an end to the darkness. These people, these marvelous, marvelous specimens have been tested, no, purified, in the crucible of Tatooine's harsh environs. They alone are the hope of the galaxy. Their strength, their society, is the blueprint of our salvation.
Master Erez, you are very ill.
No, not ill, not ill at all. They are simple. But long after the Empire and the Republic are gone, these people will remain. Their culture is built around strength. They cut the weak away like a societal cancer. Don't you see? It's the only way.
The Jedi Order has a responsibility, to weak and strong alike.
How can I make you understand? They are the ultimate warriors purified by hardship. We must follow their example and cut away everything that would make us weak in the face of our adversaries, the frail, the diseased.
You're not thinking straight. Now, look, I'm sick, Erez. You gonna cast me out too?
I have no choice. We must fortify the Republic with its strongest members and send this army of light out against the darkness.
An army of light that neglects the weak is no longer light.
You fools! To oppose me is to reveal your own weakness. You will be cast out.
Trust me, weakness. That's quite enough of that.
No, wait. Before you strike the killing blow, listen to me. I hear Lord Vivica's voice. I've failed him, just as I failed my old friend Porcanus when he died.
Why does everyone mention Porcanus?
I don't know, but I keep thinking about our first mission. Our ill-fated mission to Malachor III. We were all weak. We all came under the thrall of the dark side. We did things we regretted, but Porcanus was our strength. As we tried to escape, I fell behind, and he ran back to save me. He became trapped. We had to leave him. It was my weakness that killed him.
It's hard to lose a friend like that, but you have to move on.
I'm trying to. That is the purpose of this project. Think about it. The Jedi Order spends so much time protecting the helpless and caring for the sick, when we could be fighting the Empire. You must kill me. I was weak on Malachor III, and I'm weak now. But you must take my findings before the Council. Promise me that.
We'll discuss that in a second.
What? What was that? You... He's gone. Somehow you've driven Lord Vivicor away. I no longer hear his voice. I almost wish you hadn't done that.
Of all the ungrateful, impudent... This Jedi saved your life.
Lord Vivicor twisted my mind. And I'm glad to be free of him. Still, my discovery remains. From these sand people, I have learned the key to building the unstoppable army. I feel I must bring these findings to the Republic. Yet, I can't shake this feeling that some truths are best left buried in the sand.
Using this information would mean the sacrifice of every good the Republic stands for.
You're right. These records are no more. Thank you for your guidance, and for saving me from Vivica's grasp.
Well, Jedi, I'm glad Master Erez is alive and his own self. Best get back to Anchorhead myself. Sand Rot's acting up, and, well, frankly, sort of miss Darth Nurse's hollering.
Thank you for all you've done.
Good luck with whatever it is you're doing, Jedi. Hope you find this Lord Vivicar.
Master Erez has reported back to the Council. Good work. He speaks of discoveries on Tatooine. We intend to hear his full report when he returns to Coruscant. Did you discover anything more about the Plague Master, this Lord Vivekar?
Master Erez seemed to think that Vivekar was why he kept remembering Malachor III and his friend Parcanis.
A connection between the events on Malachor III and our current circumstances is clearly forming. The Council will continue its own investigation into the matter. Meanwhile, hurry to Alderaan. So long as Lord Vivekar has control of even one master, he will grow in power.
I understand perfectly.
Good. Do not delay. Every wasted moment works in Lord Vivekar's favor.